This is the PlayStation Access controller. It's similar to the Xbox Adaptive controller. Both are meant to be an alternative to the standard controller on each platform. Both controllers allow you to customize your setup with external buttons and joysticks. They have these 3.5mm jacks. The PlayStation Access controller has 4 of them, and the Xbox Adaptive controller has 19 of them. You can use a cable with 3.5mm plugs, same as the ones typically used for audio, to connect an external switch or button, and then in the system software of each console you can define what function you want that button to have. Similarly, there are analog joysticks that you can connect using a 3.5mm TRRS cable and use them as the left stick or the right stick. A TRRS cable is a cable with 4 wires, normally it's used for headphones with a microphone. And here's the important difference between these two controllers. What if you don't want to use a specialized joystick that has a 3.5mm plug? What if you already have a USB joystick that you like and you want to use it as the left stick or the right stick on your console? On Xbox, it's easy. The Xbox Adaptive controller, in addition to its 19 3.5mm jacks, also has 2 USB input ports located on each side. If you plug the joystick into the port on the left side, it will function as the left analog stick. If you plug the joystick into the port on the right side, it will function as the right analog stick. But the PlayStation Access controller doesn't have USB inputs. It only has these 3.5mm ports. As you no doubt have guessed by now, we are going to solve this situation with HID Remapper. Typically, HID Remapper is used to take a USB device and either slightly modify its behavior or make it work as some other USB device. For example, you might use it to make a keyboard work as a mouse, or you might use it to make a button on your mouse send some key combination. But today, we are going to use it to take a USB device like this joystick and turn it into an analog joystick compatible with this 3.5mm jacks on the PlayStation Access controller. This is HID Remapper custom board V7. I know, I should really work on the naming scheme, but anyway, it's one of the many variants of HID Remapper. It has 4 USB inputs, and we can plug our joystick and other USB devices here. It also has 14 3.5mm output ports. 4 of these ports are analog and the rest of them are digital. The analog outputs can be used for sticks and triggers, and the digital outputs can be used for buttons. What we are going to do is we're going to connect some of these outputs to the 3.5mm inputs on the PlayStation Access controller, and then we're going to configure HID Remapper to take the signals from this USB joystick, the movement of the stick and maybe some button presses, and send them out over these 3.5mm outputs. Essentially, we're going to make an adapter. This way, we'll be able to use our USB joystick with the PlayStation Access controller, even though it doesn't have USB inputs of its own. Okay, let's do it. First, let's connect an analog stick output to one of the inputs on the PlayStation Access controller using a TRRS cable. And by the way, any of the ports on the PlayStation Access controller can be used for joysticks, triggers and buttons, but on HID Remapper custom board V7, there are dedicated ports for each device type. These two ports are for analog sticks, this one and this one. These two ports are for analog triggers, and the rest of them are for buttons, the digital outputs. Let's connect one of the analog outputs to one of the ports on the PlayStation Access controller. And let's connect one of the digital outputs as well. We're going to use that for a button on the joystick. For this, we will use a mono cable. Okay. We connected our HID Remapper to the PlayStation Access controller. Let's also connect the USB joystick to HID Remapper. And now let's configure it so that it actually does what we need it to do. This is what the configuration interface looks like. It's just a website you go to configure your HID Remapper. You set things up here, and then you save the configuration to your device. At this time, it needs to be connected to your computer over USB. The way you typically use HID Remapper is that you configure it on the same computer that you're using it on. But in our case, we'll be using it on our PS5 and configuring it on a separate machine. The great thing about it is that we can make changes to the configuration and immediately see the effect live on the PS5. Later, when you're happy with the configuration and you're just using it, you can connect the HID Remapper to any USB port. It just needs to be powered. You can use a port on your PS5 for this or any other USB port. Okay, let's connect the HID Remapper to our computer. I won't be getting into too much detail about the configuration interface, I'm just going to show the parts that we need for our use case. First, let's connect to our HID Remapper, open device, select our device. Okay. This tab, the mappings tab, is where we tell HID Remapper to map some things to other things. There's the input and there's the output. If we knew what the thing we want to map from is named, in our case it's the X and Y axis of this joystick, we could just click on the input button and find it on the list. But sometimes the thing we want to map won't be on this list, or it will have some weird name. Fortunately, there's a way around it. If you want to see what inputs the device that you plugged in is sending to HID Remapper, you can go to the monitor tab and then start moving the joystick, pressing the buttons and so on. Here we can see what inputs the joystick is sending. When I move the stick, we can see that the cursor X and cursor Y numbers are changing. When I press the trigger, we can see that it sends left button. Let's use these three inputs and map them to the 3.5 mm jacks. There's a neat little shortcut that we can use here. If we press the little plus button next to the input in the monitor, it creates a mapping with that thing set as input. Let's do that. I'll just delete the first mapping that we don't need. Okay. We have the input set. Now we need to set the output. If we click the output button, we get a list of things. It's a very long list, but we're looking for the analog outputs. There are six of them. Analog 0 to analog 5. And why are there six of them? We have four analog outputs, two for sticks and two for triggers. Each stick needs two channels, X and Y, and each trigger needs one. Okay. Now I happen to know, because I read the documentation and also because I made this, that the analog output that we have plugged our first cable into corresponds to channels 0 and 1. We are currently doing the X-axis, which is analog 0. Let's do the same thing for the Y-axis of the joystick. We go to the monitor tab again. We click the little plus button next to the Y-axis input. And let's set the output to analog 1. By the way, the other stick is analog 2 and 3, and the triggers are analog 4 and 5. Okay, let's also do one button. Back in the monitor tab, we identified that the input that is sent for the trigger on the joystick is left button. We click the little plus button, the input in our mapping is set. Now we just need to set the output. It will be called GPIO something. But which one? Ideally, it would be marked on the outside of the device, but I happen to have the bare PCB here. It's the same PCB that's inside this. And it says that the output that we plugged our mono cable into is GPIO 11. So we select GPIO 11. And we're all set. We have three mappings, two of which are for the axis of the joystick and one for the button. Let's go to our PS5 and see if it works. The 3.5mm input jacks on the PlayStation Access controller don't have their functions set by default, so we have to assign them. Hold the profile button, go to profile library, edit the profile, button assignments. We have our virtual analog stick plugged into E1 and our virtual button plugged into E4. I will assign left stick to E1 and I will assign the R1 button to E4. As you can see, the controller is smart and knows that we plugged an analog stick to E1 and a button to E4 and only lets us choose from those functions. Okay. Let's try a game and see if it works. Let's try the joystick. I am now controlling Kratos with the joystick. And let's try the button. The button works too. Awesome! We have successfully connected a USB joystick to the PlayStation Access controller, even though it has no USB inputs of its own. What we just did is the most basic setup, and various more complex configurations are possible with HID Remapper. If we go back to the configuration interface and back to the monitor tab, we can see that the joystick generates a lot more inputs. If I twist the joystick around the vertical axis, we can see that it generates some inputs here. If I move this throttle slider, it generates some inputs here. Each of these axes and every button could be mapped to something. We could connect a second joystick and use it as the right analog stick. Or we could connect a keyboard or a mouse and use the flexible remapping engine that HID Remapper has and map them to joystick outputs or triggers or buttons. The only real limitation here is that, sadly, the PlayStation Access controller only has four 3.5mm jacks. You can get a second one and use two of them together, but even then, that's only 8 inputs in total. Okay, that's it for this video. If you have any questions or if there's some topic related to HID Remapper that you would like to see covered in a future video, please leave a comment. For general information about HID Remapper, see the GitHub repository. Thanks for watching.